Hello everyone, welcome back to another episode of PSA Monday, and in today's episode we have two new guests, with one returning guest being Violet. She is back yet again, but anyways, I'm excited. This is the fourth episode of PSA Monday, so let's go to introduce the guests. So here we have our new guests, and obviously we will introduce our returning guest, which is Violet.
Hi, I'm Violet.
Oh god. Oh god. Are you for real? Oh god. Oh god.
I love you.
But anyways, the next guest without that Rickroll this time is Kieran. Feel free to introduce yourself.
What's up? My name's Donnie. I'm Kieran. You can call me anything really. Do we put down basic information or?
No, you've done all the work.
No, you dox yourself.
You dox yourself.
Don't dox yourself.
Don't dox yourself.
Be an epic gamer. Dox yourself.
You just say, "Hey, what's up? I'm a gamer."
Oh, John.
As you can tell, I'm kind of a comedian. So I'm kind of a comedian.
No, fair you're enough. Not.
All right, and the last and final guest we have is Big Old Bumblebee. Feel free to introduce yourself.
Hi, my name's B. I'm the youngest here. I'm the baby. But that's about it for me.
The baby? Let's go.
Yeah.
Okay, Minecraft update.
Oh my god.
Okay, Minecraft B update.
Thank you.
The baby.
Let's go.
I was gonna do that.
Let's go. Oh boy.
You got a bunch of comedians that. Well, I'm not even a middle schooler, but like
we got a bunch of Gen Z here.
Yeah, pretty much.
The first PSA is called a candy factory. Good old America.
That sounds interesting.
Child abuse.
This sounds 2006.
Yep.
I think I was around five. I was four at this time.
Oh damn.
Oh wow,
that slaps.
I was like six.
Oh.
Yo, that tomato is coked up though.
Bro, he's kind of hot, low key. I'm joking.
Oh god.
Yeah, low key.
God, that's.
You better tell somebody.
That's a sexy rat.
That
is a sexy rat though.
Hey, this isn't candy. Yeah, it's tobacco.
What did you think about that one?
What was your first clue?
That one was definitely new. I'm not gonna lie. The beginning of it was definitely all cheery and everything. Kind of reminded me of the game Candyland.
Yeah, fair enough.
But also, too, those faces kind of reminded me of something. Like, of those. Remember those, like, early stop motion animations with Clay?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like Wallace and Gromit or something. Like Wallace and Gromit or Robot Chicken. That's kind of what it reminded me of.
Yeah,
like,
it kind of reminded me of a. It looks straight up like a robot chicken because they got the
It really does.
The model characters, not the mouths and shit too.
Yeah, it looks like
color sort of.
Ty Bailey.
Like it looks straight up like a robot chicken. Willy Wonka and the Robot Chicken Factory. There we go.
Willy Wonka and the Tobacco Factory.
Yeah, that's pretty much
Wonka
it.
And the Tobacco Factory.
I'd make that a movie.
That's pretty much
dude,
it.
Dude, that should be a movie.
Honestly.
Like, I would actually pay money to see that.
Fair enough.
Same.
Alright.
Willy Wonka.
We have got our next one.
Yeah, put her in a cage. She's on top of there.
Before we move on to this next one, thumbs up or thumbs
Ten
down?
10 minutes.
Thumbs up. I'd give it a thumbs up.
I'll give it a 6 out of 10.
Fair enough.
Yeah, 6 out of 10.
That's
we're not
like
really
solid,
1 to 10 ratings. We're doing thumbs up or thumbs down. Get with the program.
1 to 10 is fine. Don't stress. Shush, Violet. Alright, next one is called Cleaning Girl. So you've probably seen this one.
Oh, I remember this one. I remember this one.
Oh, I know what this one is.
I don't know why it's like 144p, but.
Oh, man.
Oh, someone else joined. I didn't even know. Oh, not
the cleanest house on the street.
Yo, activate G-Force experience. It popped up on the screen.
That was ironic. I remember this one. I like how they just make it so cheery. Like, what? Yeah. Excuse me?
Exactly.
So what are your thoughts?
No, you're not going to happen anyway.
What are your thoughts on this one?
Something ironic actually happened while we were watching that one. When it said, "Get these bugs all out of my place," I saw a fly by out of the corner of my eye.
Oh god! Perfect timing. Straight up, perfect timing.
Irony. Oh god, I've seen this one in a PSA compilation before. I think it was "Hello, I'm a pizza."
Yep. Yeah, I imagine.
Yeah, I think that's where I found mine too.
Or Gabby the Clown. When I first saw this one, it kind of reminded me of someone I knew, because obviously.
I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing.
It's a bad thing. Yes. It's a bad thing. It's a very bad thing.
Because it's like they could just be a person that likes to clean. I don't know, but well,
they're on meth. Like, oh, dude, honestly, the difference between meth and the other thing, one makes you productive, but one just, I don't know.
Hey, I love TikTok. They just took down one of my videos.
Woo!
They took down two, actually.
No. Copyright strikes. 101.
Nah, it's just the stupid whatchamacallit, this stupid recording system.
Community guidelines get you.
Yeah. Oh.
I had one of my videos removed because it violated community guidelines, and it was a video of me and a guy just like goofing off, like split screen.
The Ninja Turtles PSA I posted got taken down for illegal activity.
There's a PSA for Ninja Turtles?
Yeah.
I want to see that.
I think.
Before the next one, we'll go and watch that one, actually.
I'm not a chicken. You're a turkey.
I'll tell you what.
What?
The alternate version. Oh, fuck, that's loud. This is the alternate version of Cleaning Girl.
This one's actually pretty. This one actually is quite shocking, I'm not gonna lie.
It went straight through my fucking ears when it started playing, though.
Now, this shows the true nature of meth. Out of the scare factor, I mean, when you're first viewing this, when you're like about 5 or something, it would definitely scare you, but now you're just more aware of.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Well, I think this one makes it a bit more accurate with how it portrays meth, but I feel like the other one's just a lot more memorable.
It is. Yeah, it's a lot more memorable.
The other one's just catchy.
Yeah, you're not wrong. Like this
like,
one.
I remember going to school, humming the song, and people are like, "Oh, hey, what song is that?" And I was like,
I don't know if I should say that.
I don't know if I should say that.
Fair enough. Next minute they go watch the PSA, and they're like, meth. Meth.
Hence why I was only humming it.
Fair enough. Honestly, fair enough.
Because the other one feels like it was just...
Yeah, it's just straight up catchy, the other one. This one, I feel like it's just... It does get it across a bit more accurately, but I just feel like this one isn't as memorable.
Mm-hmm.
So thumbs up, thumbs down?
Thumbs up.
Fair enough. Next one's a very short one. Oh, fuck. So this next one is called Pull Your Finger Out. It's like 10 seconds long.
Pull my finger.
Make a copper or save your family from dying. Pull your finger out. Test your smoke alarm.
That escalated quickly.
Yeah.
Wow. That escalated very quickly. 10 out of
10. 10 out of 10.
Pull your finger out. I just love that bit.
Like, what was it?
It's show style, isn't it?
The finger is out.
It's basically Saturday
it's
aware.
Tuesday, isn't it?
It's Tuesday, isn't it? Oi, bruv.
Oi, bruv.
Oi, bruv. It's Tuesday.
Oi, Micah. Lovely day, isn't it? Right is right. Right is right.
Oi, mate, you want a copper?
Check the front door. You want a copper?
Oh, my God.
Hey, mate, don't we put the kettle on? Like, fucking hell. Oh, God. But yeah, what did you think of that one? Thumbs up, thumbs down.
In the middle.
That went from 0 to 100 real quickly.
Yeah, you're not wrong. You're not wrong at all. Alright, so we'll get straight into the next one. It's called Blue Sticks.
I'm carrying this up, I'm saving this. Yes, it did.
Blue Sticks?
Yeah, Blue Sticks.
Sounds like Joy. Nobody admitted they
didn't like them. Worse fair enough. Still, the sticks were poisonous
and caused terrible damage to their bodies. Excuse
me. I want wheels as legs. Said
until one of them, who was trying it for the first time, said, it's for PSAs. They kind of also remind me of Death Sticks, low-key.
Fair enough. What'd you think of that?
Okay, that was...
The animation's how I really liked.
Yeah, not
from
Scotland.
I really did like the animation. The animation was really cute.
The art style looked real nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, it looked aesthetically pleasing.
I can agree with that.
That's coming from an artist. Like a little cartoon doodle. Colors!
I actually did a drawing of my favorite Vocaloid today. Because I like
Vocaloid. I used to draw, but like I have like a picture of Broly in one of my sketchbooks somewhere, and...
Yeah, I barely ever draw. I half can't be bothered. It takes too long.
How to get better at art, 101. Step one, circles. Practice. Immediately disconnect. Why
yeah,
does anyone
much.
Leave at step one?
So what'd you think of Blue Sticks? Thumbs up, thumbs down?
Thumbs up.
Yeah.
Thumbs up. It was
I think it's just kind of average.
It was pretty good.
Drawing 101. I'll give it a draw circle. Step two. Step one, draw
practice.
Circle. Step two, done.
This next one, legit just says it in the name.
Jeffrey Dahmer?
Ooh.
There you go.
Okay, this is a serial killer.
There you go. You already spoiled it for everyone. Good job.
It's Jeffrey. I'm sorry. I'm kind of a serial killer nerd. I'm sorry.
Nah, fair enough.
Same.
Ooh. I never knew that. He decapitated a dog and mounted the head on a. Oh my god.
Lol.
In his 20s, he's like to strip off the roadkill. I mean, they're already dead, so I mean.
Still a bit weird.
Still a bit sus, but...
Yeah. Bro, that's a bit sus.
Oh no, bro.
So what'd you think of that?
What shocked me the most was he decapitated dogs and placed them on stakes.
Yeah, it is yikes.
That's actually kind of disturbing.
Yeah, no, it is. It really is.
You think his parents would have been like, hey, bestie, you good?
I think Jeffrey Dahmer.
Either that or they were just like, oh, yeah, this animal abuse from our son.
Would have just gone in the middle of the forest and just killed him.
Yeah, if I remember correctly, he used to lure animals in or something.
Yeah, it makes
like,
sense.
Like, used to lure stray animals in or something.
Honestly, it makes sense. But it's fucked up.
It's fucked up.
In the middle.
Thumbs up. That's pretty good. Useless, but yet interesting serial killer knowledge.
Hey, someone else came in the middle of recording.
Hello. Oh, who is this?
Boom.
Oh.
Jeffrey Dahmer. Wow.
Boom.
Bum 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 bum.
Oh, okay, this next one is called Hearing the Truth
Burns. The dog. But at least they clarified that no animal.
Cowboy.
Didn't we watch this?
Did we? I don't think we did.
Hey, is he smoking those cowboy killers?
Do you use
hey,
the
Jotaro,
like
look at
though?
This! Grabs Jotaro Nando.
No, he burned his car.
Oh no, not the children maker.
Dude, his dick's legit steaming. What the fuck? Oh, shut up, Conan.
Bro, that's cut. Hey, Conan.
Hey, Jotaro, you see that smoking PSA? Yeah, don't do that.
He's cocky burning.
Jotaro, no. Yeah, the chicken DV cooking though.
What did you think about that one?
Wonder what it would taste like.
That's just funny.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Jotaro accidentally kills Abzal's chickens.
Oh, no.
That one was more funny, but that actually can happen to you.
Yeah, but it's very, very unlikely.
Yeah, it is very unlikely, but it's still a possibility.
Oh, yeah, it's extremely likely because you got to think about, like, who owns a horse.
Have you ever accidentally burned yourself?
Yeah.
Actually, Cowboys did in the Wild West.
I accidentally burned my cock and balls. Good job.
That's a whole different type of CBT, my dude.
Oh, God. So what do you think about that PSA?
Burn my cock with a cigarette, I must. Maximum pleasure, I will do.
Burn my cock.
Burn my cock with the cock and balls with matchbook, I must. Maximum pleasure, I will endure. I want that animated. I want that animated.
Thumbs up, thumbs down.
Thumbs up.
I know a good one. I know a good funny Yoda meme. Yoda, it's like an ASMR, and Yoda reads all the side effects of cigarettes.
Oh, God.
We need to watch that. We need to watch that.
Okay. I'll send it in the PSA chat, since technically it is a PSA. But it's more like a meme.
Yeah, I'll probably watch it up after we've recorded this episode. Like, I'll put it on after we've recorded it. So this next one, I don't know if I've showed it or not. I know I've talked about it.
Master of Puppets. Ooh, is this referencing a Metallica album?
No, it's not.
Oh my God.
And it's not even, these PSAs are not even called Master of Puppets. It's just they named it this for some dumb reason. The actual PSA is called Shadow Puppets. So, Shadow Puppets. And it's another one.
That's a really bad JoJo.
Please don't tell me this involves dolls.
Involves what?
Dolls. I'm not a big fan of dolls.
It doesn't involve dolls.
Oh, I like this one.
Birdie.
Tweet, tweet. Hey, Sky, it's you.
Durf.
And then ready for this one. Zwan.
Zwan.
Zwan. Hey, look, it's Harold.
Coinjin.
Coonijin. Coonijin.
Camille. And then ready for the
Olifant.
Uh-oh, Spaghetti-O.
Run.
Run means moron, by the way.
Oh,
nice.
What language is it?
I think it's German.
I think it's Dutch.
Dutch.
But, I have a translation of this end text somewhere. Fuck. Hold on.
It's something like, if you mess with fireworks,
yeah, I put it in one of my videos. I actually had the end text translation.
I think this is like...
I think it's like, you're a moron when you snap with fireworks or something like that.
Yeah.
Yeah, so what did you think of that one?
That one was definitely...
10 tenths.
Oh, God. 10 tenths.
I mean, it's pretty good. Thumbs up. 9 out of 10.
I can agree with that. I think this is probably the best fireworks.
And I mean, since 4th of July is tomorrow for the Merkins in the chat.
I feel like I just really like this because it's simplistic.
BF got snacks.
Yeah, fair enough. Oh, God. I just spoiled it. Oh, no.
He's the alligator.
I just spoiled it. $100 million worth. What's it been? Maybe 30
years off TV? Yeah, long time. Too long. Yeah, just time. Long. We just stay away from this. I'll just stay with the C word. Cancer? We don't say anything about
on the tube. Maybe I'll teach you.
We talk about community service.
We talk about the Sims for a croc.
Bingo.
I saw people comment on your TikTok like, is that bingo?
What?
Some people are just straight up Sims. It's so weird.
Yum, alligator.
Yep.
But that's a cool pose though.
Yeah, no, I agree with that.
I love the smile. I love that smile.
Yeah, no, it's great. Pose. I do get some comments of people actually saying like, oh yeah, it is cool animation. But some people are straight up Sims.
It is a pretty cool animation, though, not gonna lie.
Yeah, I can agree with that. 100%.
People who simp for this alligator are the same people who swear they're not furries. Prove me wrong.
Yeah.
Exactly.
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 Right.
You guys know me. This isn't gonna. This is gonna be obvious what it is.
Oh, the mannequins.
Thank you.
He's vibing.
They do be vibing.
They vibing in a junkyard though.
That was a sick guitar turn. That was a sick guitar twirl.
Yeah, I can hear that.
He did it again.
Yep.
That's pretty badass.
So what did you think of that one?
Thumbs up.
Yep.
That was a thumbs up for sure.
I love
that.
Has to be a thumbs up. Has to be a thumbs up.
That's right.
That's a thumbs up for me.
Thumbs up.
I want them to come back, but they won't.
Yeah.
Very sad. They're so good. Like, they're just unmatched. Straight up.
They're just vibing, bro. Vibing mannequins are definitely where it's at.
Exactly.
They're best friends, I will admit.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
They went through a lot together. Unfortunately, they went through that car crash together.
Awesome.
Yep.
Yeah. What? Everything isn't awesome.
So this next PSA, basically takes inspiration from the Lego movie to push a message to Lego.
Uh-oh. They're talking about plastic usage?
Yeah, no.
No.
Oh, is this about the Antarctic and global warming?
Kind of.
Huh.
Oh, Master Chief.
I love Lego. Ghost.
Colonization.
Yo, you better leave them fish alone, boy, or those polar bears get you.
I'm gonna get copyrighted if I decide to sing.
We both will.
Oh, it's an oil spill.
Yep.
Fish.
Oh no.
Fishies.
Oh no, it's the Titanic.
If I try to sing this song, I will get copyrighted.
Oh no, the doggos! No, not the polar bear! Not the Coca-Cola! No. No, not the chihuahua!
No, the baby's dead.
No, the owl! Redwing, baby!
Emmett and Wild Style, no!
No!
There goes Satan! Oh.
And there goes David.
David.
There goes David.
There goes the last polar bear in existence.
That was the last male in the last.
I love it how they add that these was... videos to ruin it.
Not David. Anybody but David.
David.
And then there's David.
No. So what do you think of that one?
I like it. It is very calming.
Yeah.
I like it.
I think you get
the it's not. 10 out of 10 would play that song on a 10-hour loop to fall asleep to. Slow to reverb.
Over and over again.
Reverb.
I definitely think it's a thumbs up. And yeah.
It's a thumbs up.
Bit of reverb.
Ooh, nice.
Thumbs up.
We got two more to go.
I am witnessing a fighter's match between my little brother and boyfriend. I wonder how this is gonna go.
Oh god. Alright.
This next
one's called Smoking Dog. If you watch JonTron, you know what it is.
Oh yeah. My god, I know this one.
I'm a dog, what's your excuse?
I better look.
I'm smoking,
I'm a dog.
That's how the dog talks.
I'm smoking,
that's how the dog talks.
Hey, yo, I'm smoking here!
Hey, I'm a dog.
I'm a dog.
What's your excuse? He taps the cigarette, too. I didn't even realize that. I didn't even realize that. Watch this. He taps the cigarette, like, to...
I fucking love that dog.
I never even noticed.
Let's see it one more time.
Ready?
What's your excuse?
I didn't even notice.
That's a bro moment, indeed.
What'd you think of that one?
That's a solid JonTron
and the Brooklyn accent we decided to add in there.
Yeah.
I'm trying to smoke here. I'm a dog. What's your excuse? Cap cigarette.
Hashtag not all dogs, thanks. Some dogs these days. I think they put all of us in
not all dogs.
Not all dogs.
Not all
dogs. Hey, I'm a dog. Yeah. What's your excuse? Bro, I have plenty of excuses. What's your excuse? I'm just a dog, bro.
I'll legit just give this one a thumbs up for how meme-worthy it is. Thanks to John.
The fucking tap of the paw. Let's see it just one more time before you close this.
Right. One more time.
One more time.
Right.
One more time.
Dog.
What's your excuse?
It's so confusing.
The fucking paw. How is he holding that cigarette?
Honestly, it looks like it's in the middle of his paw. Like, how is he holding it? Why isn't it the end?
We don't ask questions here. Honestly. We don't ask questions honestly. About that. We should ask him why he's smoking the cigarettes.
Honestly.
Hey, I'm a dog. Hey, I'm a dog. What's your excuse?
Not going to say anything about this one. Just watch. Because your two special guests won't even notice
this. Oh, no, I know what it is! I saw the title!
Yes.
Yes.
Hi, Biggie Bear. Hi, Biggie Bear. How are you?
This is the only one I haven't showed.
I told you not to come here anymore. Get out of here. This is my show. What's the matter, Vicky?
Oh my god.
The mafia.
Oh no. Yakuza fights in another
show. The rabbit secretly borrowed 10 grand.
Oh god, he got a gun. Oh shit. Biggie Bear's packing some heat. Oh shit, he shot him!
He's fucking dead.
Oh shit! Oh, he's fucking dead.
What shoes he got on?
Bro, he didn't even give a warning shot. He just flat out put it in his mouth and pulled the trigger.
Nah, he's straight up dead. He borrowed 10 grand of coke off him, so. Nah, he's straight up dead.
Dude, he didn't pay back his loan.
Exactly. What did you think of that one?
Biggie Bear was just there to collect the debt.
Oh.
I need to hear your thoughts on this.
Biggie Bear, the debt collector.
Biggie Bear, the loan shark. He didn't even kneecap him. He just flat out took his life.
Biggie Bear says debt collecting is great.
It's the only time where I can legally kill.
Okay.
Oh, that does seem like a kind
Biggie
of
Bear part
good
of the
job.
So thumbs up, thumbs down.
No, Biggie Bear is part of. Biggie Bear is part of the Yakuza. What are you talking about?
That's true.
He's part of the Dozuma family, man.
Legit. Oh my god.
I'll give it a thumbs up.
I loved it.
I love it for how insane it is.
Groups of PSAs because it's so funny.
Yeah, legit.
Oh shit! Biggie Bear has some packing some heat. He's pulling out the Glock 90.
Yeah, he's straight up packing heat.
He pulled out the Glock 90, my guy.
Oh shit!
Oh, the Glock 9.
Oh god.
Nani, you pulled out the Glock 9. Proceeds to put Glock 9 in your mouth.
Nani?
Oh god.
Nani and the Nissan. What are you doing with that Glock 9? This is the end of your day.
You see, this is all part of your training. I'm just simply gonna shoot you and see if you dodge it.
Proceeds to put Nashima in chapter 3. Hey, Sagawa. Yeah, you're not getting those 500,000 yen because I'm taking your life.
Oh,
Pew.
All right. So
wait. Are you talking about? Is this a Yakuza 4 reference?
That was a Yakuza 0 reference.
Sajim. Oh yeah. I'm in Yakuza 4. It's been a while since I played 0, but anyways.
Yeah, I'm on 0 because I haven't played it a lot. I've been playing other games.
It's definitely good.
Oh,
but
no.
Biggie Bear.
Yeah, it is.
Instead of Biggie Bear says hello, Biggie Bear is packing heat. That should be the name of it.
Yeah, pretty much.
Biggie Bear is packing heat.
He's straight up packing heat.
Biggie Bear is packing heat.
If you've seen the other two, though.
Americans. Hey, yo, he's in the work strapped.
Like this one. I don't know what to say about that one.
Lip bite emoji.
Biggie Bear, the sex offender. That's all I can say with that one.
Who is sex offender? How did Biggie Bear offend him?
No. Oh, God. All right, so anyways, thank you all for joining me with PSA Monday. This is the fourth episode of PSA Monday. I really appreciate it. Check out my stuff. Like the video, comment, subscribe. Special stuff at 500 subs. Do it. Sub.
Sub.
Watch my video. I'll comment.
You should totally come to my channel.
Biggie Bear, straight up packing heat. Yeah.
I'll comment.
Yeah, if you came to work, you guys subscribe to me.
Comment Big Chungus in the comments, and I'll be happy.
Big Chungus, yeah.
All right.
All right. Thank you all for watching once again. Thank you to my special guest for coming on with this episode of PSA Monday. And anyways, we will see you all in the next PSA Monday episode. Bye, people.
Biggie Bear proceeds to put some gun in your mouth. Subscribe to the video.